Hey guys, my name is Mike with Charged MTB, and I am bringing you here my new Suron X bike, or also known as the Light B. I picked this guy up from Luna Cycles. I ordered it about a week and a half ago and received it yesterday, so pretty quick shipping. This thing came boxed pretty nicely, very well boxed. Everything was protected. There was no issues with the boxes, no issue with the item itself. Everything was intact, nothing broken. Everything looked great when I received it. I went ahead and unboxed everything, put it all together. I was anxious to get it on the trail. So it had 70% left on the battery when I picked it up. I got off work early and I went up and hit my typical moto trails that I ride very near my home. So as far as that's concerned, this thing impressed me a lot. I did have quite a few doubts about its performance, how it would handle the trails, how the suspension would perform, and just, you know, the overall fit and finish of the bike. You know, I've been reading the reviews, reading the forums, you know, checking out all of the resources that I could find. I was pretty confident that the bike would be what I was hoping for. But of course, you know, until you actually get it, you just don't know. So I took it out on the dirt bike trails, took a few minutes, you know, to get warmed up on it. After about 20 minutes, I was just grinning from ear to ear and couldn't believe how well this thing was performing. It was doing hill climbs as well, if not better, than my two-stroke Beta Cross Trainer. I was just railing trails faster and more confidently than on my dirt bike. I am from a mountain bike background, and this thing is just fits perfectly for the type of riding that I do and the type of trails that I have here. So beyond that, again, you know, I'm going to try and put some ride videos together for you guys so you can see what I'm riding and how this thing handles the type of riding that I am doing and the type of trails that I'm riding, which are typically pretty steep, up and down, really rutted, and this time of year, very loose granitic soils. As soon as we get some weather here and some rain, the trails will become much more tacky and better. I plan on doing some setup rides where I'm showing you how this thing does doing specific climbs and descents and just what this thing's capable of. So the first couple of things I've done since I had it, which has only been a day, was I changed some wiring around. I didn't like the way this wire on the display and control here was routed. This was a little funky in here. This was, you know, very close to the control, which is fine, but with as long as these levers are, you can easily reach it with one finger. So I went ahead and moved them further inboard, because what I was noticing was with this being here, it was really putting a pinch on this wire and this wire here. It was just severely pinched, and I didn't like how it looked. And then also when I turned the bars all the way to the left, to the right, it was putting this wire under tremendous tension. It was actually yanking on this wire pretty hard. So I moved the wire from going underneath here, so it wrapped down and came underneath and wrapped around, and it was just too tight and I didn't like that. The second thing I've done was I swapped out the cheesy stem that comes on this bike. You know, it's a stem, it does its job, but, you know, it's pretty cheesy. I had this stem for years now, probably about 10 years, back when I was into free ride and downhill mountain biking. This is a stem that I just had around in a drawer. Never got rid of it because I always thought it was a super cool looking stem. Big, huge, beefy free ride stem from back in the old mountain bike free ride days. So I put this guy on here. It gave me a little bit more length which I wanted because the cockpit is a little cramped and it still feels a little cramped to me. Also gave me a little more rise on the stem, again, to help alleviate some of that cramped cockpit feeling that I was having, which I still feel like the bike is a little compact. I mean, obviously it's a small bike, but compared to what I'm used to riding, high-end mountain bikes and even my dirt bike, you know, they definitely feel much more roomy in the cockpit. And that, you know, when you're riding aggressively, having that room to be able to move fore and aft is huge, to be able to have control over the bike and be able to move on the bike like that. So a couple of things I'm going to do next is, one other thing is, the bike is awesome climbing. This thing climbs unbelievably well. It also descends pretty darn good. It doesn't descend like a downhill bike by any means. But the suspension, especially the Boxer, performed brilliantly. Even the D&M, the cheap D&M shock on the back, did a great job. The tires did a great job. They hooked up, especially even in the dry, decomposed granite that we have right now. Usually it's pretty slippery, and this thing was actually gripping amazingly well. It really surprised me. But on the descent, because the cockpit is so short, you feel like you want to go over the bars. And that could be, you know, because the front end is so low, you know, this fork, the Boxer, is made for a 27.5 wheel on a mountain bike. And we've got a 19-inch wheel here with the motocross tire, you know, probably putting it at around 24 inches maybe total. And then with the low-rise handlebars there, it's just putting you, you know, too far over the front of the bike when you're descending. So what I'm going to try this weekend is actually to put a 26-inch wheel and a Maxxis 2.8 DHF tire on the front. And I'm going to see if that will help to make it a better descender by bringing the front end up a little higher, so that it makes it more stable and more confident descending. If that doesn't work out, then we might put this tire back on and then just get some high-rise bars, maybe some 2-inch rise bars. And I'm also, even though I love this stem and it's big and bulky and cool-looking, I'm probably going to go direct mount just to get some better steering stability with some 2, maybe 3-inch rise bars on there if the 26-inch idea doesn't work. If the 26-inch idea works, then I'll probably keep things as they are up front. And then, you know, at some point I'll probably go with a direct mount at some point, but that's not going to happen anytime soon. So that's kind of where I'm at. I'm super happy with the bike. It performed way better than I was expecting. So much fun. Actually funner than my dirt bike. I love mountain biking as well. That's really my true passion. I dabbled in dirt biking the past couple of years. While I really liked dirt biking and I enjoyed learning how to dirt bike and the aspects of that, this thing is just feels at home to me. Because it's smaller, it's not heavy. I was just so much more confident on trails that I was scared of riding on my dirt bike because of its bulk, and hill climbs. You know, for whatever reason, I just did not feel comfortable on the two-stroke dirt bike. The same hill climb, the same technical trails that I was riding on that scared me, this felt like it was no problem. It just made my confidence so much better, and it actually handled these climbs and terrains better, in my opinion, than the dirt bike that I have. So anyways, I look forward to putting more miles on this bad boy, doing some more changes, some more additions, and documenting things as I make the changes, and documenting some riding. So anyways, this is Mike with Charged MTB. And thanks for checking out my video. Bye.